Congressman. Good evening, Democrat. How's everybody doing? Happy St. Patrick's Day. And welcome to the greatest party from the greatest congressman on the greatest day of the year. Thanks so much for being here. I want to thank all the elected officials for being here tonight. Thanks for the great work that you do across the Commonwealth of Virginia. And especially, I want to thank all of you that have taken time to come celebrate St. Patrick's Day and be with our great congressman. It is because of you that all five statewide elected officials are Democrats. And I don't know about you, but I'm proud to be a Democrat. And when we elect Democrats, good things happen in the Commonwealth of Virginia. As we travel around the Commonwealth, the crowds are getting larger, they're getting more enthusiastic. People are coming up and saying, "Ralph, how can I get involved? How can I help?" And the reason for that is that the election, the campaign that we watched in 2016 that was run on hatred, on bigotry, on fear, on discrimination, on a lot of misinformation, Americans are standing up and saying, "No, no, Mr. Trump, this is not the new America that we believe in. This is not the Commonwealth of Virginia that we believe in." And we all need to stand up and keep that narcissistic maniac on the other side of the Potomac River. I listen to folks around the Commonwealth when I travel, and people around the Commonwealth want a good job that they can support their family with. They want access to affordable and quality health care. They want to make sure that their children have access to a world-class education system, and they want to make sure that our streets and our communities are safe. We have brought in over 187,000 new jobs to the Commonwealth since Governor McAuliffe, Attorney General Mark Herron, and I took office 3 years ago. We have brought in over $14.5 billion of capital investment. Don't tell me that good things don't happen when we elect Democrats. We have made Virginia the most veteran-friendly state in this country. We effectively ended homelessness for our veterans last year. That's something that we all should be proud of. And speaking of veterans, I served during Desert Storm. I took care of wounded soldiers during that conflict. I know personally all too well what assault weapons do to human beings. There is no excuse, my friends, my fellow Virginians, there is no excuse to have assault weapons on our streets and in our society. We need to stop it. We need to make sure that all Virginians have access to affordable and quality health care, especially our women. We need to stop the discrimination against women having access to reproductive health care. I remind people all the time, there is no excuse that a group of legislators, most of whom are men, by the way, should be telling women what they should and shouldn't be doing with their bodies. It needs to stop. So we have a fight on our hands, and I want to let you know tonight, I'm ready for the fight. Are you ready to join me in the fight? That's what I'm talking about. We need to make sure that narcissistic maniac doesn't come anywhere close to Virginia, and we need to make sure together that we take Virginia to the next level. So let's work together and let's make Virginia proud. I want to be your 73rd governor of the Commonwealth of Virginia. I ask for your vote. I ask for your support on June the 13th and then on November the 7th. Let's make this happen in the Commonwealth of Virginia. God bless you all and thank you so much.